Hello everyone. As we have discussed about rusting of iron so many times in the last video, so our next topic is rusting of iron. In this video, we will discuss about rusting of iron in detail. So rusting of iron means when an iron object comes in the contact of air and water, a reddish brown layer is deposited on the iron object. This reddish brown layer is known as rust, and this process is known as rusting. As we have discussed about, when an iron object comes in the contact of air and water, a reddish brown layer is deposited on the iron object. This reddish brown layer is known as rust, and this process is known as rusting. We can write the chemical equation of a rusting. Iron means Fe, O2 because oxygen is present in the air, and water. So when an iron object comes in the contact of air and water, a reddish brown layer is deposited. This reddish brown layer, it is known as rust. Rust means Fe2O3. It is also known as iron oxide. So as we are saying, rusting means when an iron object comes in the contact of air and water, rust will occur. So we can see both the substances, air and water, both are required for rusting process. If any one substance is absent in the environment, it means air and water, any one substance is absent, rusting will not occur. As we have discussed in the last video, chemical changes are very important in our daily life. Some chemical changes are very useful to us, but some other chemical changes are also harmful for us. Some useful chemical changes like digestion, respiration, photosynthesis, making of carbon, these are beneficial or useful chemical changes. But some chemical changes are also harmful for us, like rusting. Rusting is a harmful chemical change because it damages the iron object. So we should prevent the iron object from rusting. If we are saying rusting is a harmful chemical change, so we should prevent the iron object from rusting. Now there are different ways to prevent rusting. The first method to prevent the iron object from rusting, that is applying a layer of paint on an iron object. So when we apply a layer of paint on an iron object, this layer of paint does not allow the iron object to come in the contact of air and water. So we can prevent the iron object from rusting by applying a layer of paint. Second method, that is applying a layer of grease or oil on an iron object. Similar to paint, when we apply a layer of grease or oil on the iron object, this layer of grease and oil does not allow the iron object to come in the contact of air and water. So we can prevent the iron object from rusting. Now, third method of the to prevent the iron object from rusting, that is galvanization. When we apply a layer of zinc on the iron object, this process is known as galvanization. So by applying a layer of zinc on the iron object, we can prevent the rusting because this layer of zinc does not allow the iron object to come in the contact of air and water. By this method, we can prevent the iron object from rusting. Now, fourth method to prevent the iron object from rusting, that is alloying. Alloying means when we mix two metals or non-metals is called alloying, and a new substance which is obtained by alloying, it is known as alloy. So, as we are saying, mixing of two metals or non-metals, it is called alloying, and the new substance which is obtained by alloying, this is known as alloy. So the example of alloying or alloy, it is a stainless steel. Stainless steel, it is an example of alloy because it is obtained by mixing of iron with chromium, magnesium and manganese. Now we can see in this example of stainless steel, because iron is a metal and we are mixing iron with chromium. Chromium, it is also a metal. Magnesium, it is also a metal. And manganese, it is also a metal. So we are mixing of iron with chromium, magnesium and manganese, and we are obtaining stainless steel. So this is a alloy, stainless steel, it is an alloy. Now we can see in our daily life, stainless steel utensils we use in the kitchen, and on a daily basis they wash with water and they also come in the contact of air, but they never get rusted because stainless steel, it is an alloy. Now the last topic of this chapter, that is crystallization. Crystallization means the process of forming crystals of a substance from its solution is known as crystallization. So because to obtain the crystals of a substance, first of all we have to prepare the solution of the substance. For forming the solution, we have to dissolve the solute in the solvent. Now we can prepare the solution, and from the solution we can obtain the crystals of a substance. This process is known as crystallization. Example of crystallization: by crystallization method we can obtain the crystals of a salt from sea water. Now next example of crystallization: we can obtain the crystals of copper sulfate also by crystallization method. In this process, or to obtain the crystals of copper sulfate by crystallization, first we take a cup full of water in a beaker. Then second step, that is add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid in it. Always we have to take a dilute sulfuric acid. We can't take a concentrated sulfuric acid. Now third step, that is heat the water. Then when the water starts boiling, add copper sulfate powder slowly while stirring continuously. Now the next step to obtain the crystals of copper sulfate, that is continue adding copper sulfate powder till no more powder can be dissolved, because we are adding copper sulfate powder in a water in which we have already dissolved sulfuric acid. So we have to continue adding copper sulfate powder till no more powder can be dissolved. The next step is, now we have to filter the solution, then allow it to cool. Then do not disturb the solution when it is cooling. After some time, after the cooling, we can obtain the crystals of copper sulfate. Thank you for watching my video.